The rest of this morning and early afternoon is going to go, but if it goes like the first few minutes, we're going to have a lot of fun today. Nice. There's a magic line we're looking for. 15, a little over 15 and a half. Very nice. This could be a really nice day. See you later. Well, so far, I've seen two turkeys be run out of the woods by those dogs over there. One of the turkeys flew right over my left shoulder. That was exciting. Appears to be a little cluster of fish over here. Oh yeah, that's a nice one. Look at that, Sparky. Salad. This water is so low. This pond is just choked with coontail, hydrilla, you name it. Yeah, it's a nice hefty bass right there. Very nice fat bass, look at that. He or she comes in at 16, between 16 and a quarter and 16 and a half. And I get to catch it twice. Well, look at that. Two in a row, 16 and a quarter to 16 and a half. I guess you know the drill. Just take your picture and send it to Sparky. Well, thank you, Mr. Bass. If I'm lucky enough to catch enough fish to make a video, should this be called fishing in the slop? There you go. It's kind of a shortened fatty into a TicklerZ. Yeah, decent, probably about 13 or 14. Eyeballs remain calibrated. 14. One time many years ago, before this pond remained low, water level was up a couple of feet, and this was basically a lot of coontail and hydrilla was growing out there, and these bass were up in there spawning. And you could see the stuff moving around while they're swimming around. So I just throw a worm, a little ribbon tail worm, in the pockets and bang. Maybe that's cheating, I don't know, but it was a lot of fun. Ooh, something moving right over by this tree. I'll just go ahead and catch this one. Nice shower. Tell you what, I've been getting some energetic and very spirited tugs from bluegill. They are very, very aggressive. Oh, they are. aren't quite as aggressive as this bass. Boy, I can get this big girl out of here. Come on. Work with me. Work with me. Work. Work it, baby. Work it. There's a nice fish. There you go. But you sure are a sight for sore eyes. Wow. That's a nice fish. And look at that tail. She'd been up in there starting to spawn anyway. No eggs. Very nice girl. A little over 18. Almost 18 and a half. Almost. Those are the kind of fish you like to see every now and then anyway. Okay, that was a fun fight. Nice to see a nice fish every now and then. Hopefully this will make Rudy proud. See ya. Okay, Sparky, I think I'll keep a basket of these, you know, let them ferment outside for about a week and then send them on down for you to enjoy for lunch. They're everywhere down in there. That's crazy. That could very well be why the bass in this pond have survived so well. Well, I think I have been blaming the wrong fish for those yanks on my artificial lures. It appears to me that this is some kind of a minnow. Oh, I'm gonna have to look up my fish species when I get home, see if I can identify it. Wow, now that congregation of these minnow things will definitely bring in catfish and you name it. Golden shiners, I don't know. Pretty aggressive. And I've been thinking those are bluegill. Get the shad net, Sparky. That would look really nice hanging on the wall in your boat garage. Just above your prowler. Beautiful. Beautiful. Whatever these things are, they are everywhere. Open water, mossy water, up next to the trees. This lake is infested with them. See ya. Yep, look what's over here chasing those crazy shad things. And a quarter to 16 and a half. There you go, buddy. Bastards are lying in ambush right along the edges of that grassy stuff. Looking for a shad lunch, huh? Go ahead and eat as many as you want. Well, friends, the fish have turned off the lights and hung up a sign that says the party's over. But while they were still awake and hungry, that was a lot of fun. Thanks for coming along. Hope you enjoyed the show. And from our house to your house, till we see you next time, God bless. Bye.